Hey everybody, how you doing today? I'm coming from my studio. I figured today I'll make a butterfly and do a chain pull butterfly. So you can see how the different paints work together and whatnot. It's kind of fun. And I figured, well, I'll do this video and if it gets screwed up, well, I don't have to show it. So anyway, I figured I'd just show my face in here for right now because probably for the most of the paint you might see my big fat butt. Anyway, let's get going. First we have canvas. It's a 12 by 16 canvas. And I think I've got all my stuff here. Wearing a nice old top, that's a real big help. So anyway, let's get this up and going. Alrighty. Gonna put some white paint on here to start the process going. Hopefully I got enough left. I'm trying to use up some paint that I've had. And if I don't, well, that's okay. I got other white paint. Make happy little dots. All right, that's up for that one. So I'll just take my other one. I got a different part. Now this one here has got some silicone in it, as well as Floetrol and paint and water. So we're just gonna mix this in here. Get it nice and full. Gosh, I sure hope this comes out. This would be really neat if it does. Alrighty, put that over here. And the next thing we do is want to scrape it, cover the whole canvas. Unfortunately, I don't know if my camera's got the ability to do it, but it'd be nice if I could speed this up. But anyway, you're just going to have to bear with me on this. This might be nice to do if any of you are in the area and you'd like to, once this virus is over, or to the point that businesses can open up, if you're in the area and you'd like to have a paint for fun night and we do stuff, I do stuff like this, just give me a call. Get a hold of me on Facebook or on my website, artfromtheheart.biz. It's always good to have some paper towels at the ready. Oops. Guess I'll end up having to put on one of my plastic gloves. Because I want to get some of this paint on the side a little bit. So we'll just do a little bit more.
good to me.
Okay. Now I'm going to use up some of the paints that I had. So let's start with the purple. I'm going to start right here. I'm going to try to make it in the center. As you can tell, this is very scientific. All right, so we got the first one in. Let's do another darker blue purple. Just going over here. Hope you can see it. Hope this comes out okay. I think this is going to be really pretty. All right. Now we've got some paint going on here. If you'd like to try some of this on your own, these bottles that I got here, I got these from the dollar store. Two to a package for a dollar. Can't beat that. And it helps to really kind of have a more controlled flow of the paint. All right. Next one I want to do, I'm going to do blue. Oops. Get it all over me. Oh, yellow. Got some gold in here. Oops. The yellow. Oopsie. And all these paints that I've put in here, all these paints are from Lowe's. How cool is that? On the outside. All right. Next, I gotta take my erstwhile chain. Of course, it's all scrunched up. And here's the chain right here. Got that from Lowe's over in the lampshade department. And we're gonna start by very carefully taking the chain and just laying it down and going around the outside.
the outside cover. Gonna do this, pull it. Oh, isn't that pretty? And white. Hopefully you can see that. So we'll go again. Start on the outside. Follow the outside color. Gently lay it down right to the center. Get on. See, there's an abundance of paint. Okay, let's start over. And your last one. Stick this right over here for now. And I've taken my top of a, what do you call it, skewer, wooden skewer, cut it off so we can make, see how this works. No, I have to get something a little thicker than that. Yep. So I'm gonna take one of these. Just run it through the paint. If you like what you're saying, just give me a comment. Really like to hear from you. sometimes you wonder when you're doing stuff, they're probably I'm thinking, oh gosh, they're probably gonna say, oh no, it's her again. Okay, what do I do with my heat gun? One last thing I gotta look for. Oh, there it is. Alrighty. Let's see if this brings up a lot of cells here. Oops. I need to cover that. This down here. No. Look at all those pretty cells coming up from here. Very pretty. I love working the heat gun over here because it's amazing what it creates on top of getting rid of the air bubbles. And I think I'm just going to leave the antennas alone. Really nice. Oh, I like it. Okay. So that's how you make a butterfly with a pull string. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the camera off and just give you a look-see in the next video. So thanks for stopping by and leave a comment if you like. If you'd like to join a class after this is over with, give me a holler. Thank you. Take care. Have a good day.